قال ولا فرد واحد كل قرية، لأن قرية منطقة عين عرب كبيرة، كل قرية يخلي محله يجي على القرية تاني ويجي من ورانا تاني يجي على القرية تاني يجي.
It's just the biggest influx that Turkey have seen so far. The needs are urgent, needs are so big. Most of them are women and children. كله خوف الخوف من شو كلنا طلعنا من البيت من القصف عشان هيك الولاد كلهم مرضانين شو بعرفني الله يعين العالم.
What is shocking is that 2014 was the year of highest number of forcefully displaced persons ever recorded, with 60 million altogether. And it definitely is an escalating crisis.
Allahu Akbar!
Things really are getting out of control simply because this world seems to be a world at war.
They flee from persecution, from human rights violations, and from the crippling poverty.
من العالم سعادة هيك يعني العيجان الصبح بدو يعني بدو يسوي لهم مفطور ما بيشي ايش بدو يسوي.
It definitely is a human rights issue. The core of human rights is freedom from fear and freedom from want. And those are triggers of emigration.
The international community seems not to have capacity to prevent conflicts and to timely solve them. Some of them get totally out of control. If you look at Syria and Iraq, now we have 15 million people displaced in and from the two countries.
اجبر جبا بير ما بو ما بازا نقول برو كندم بو ما تينا فاندران ما تركا كندد خدايا ما تشاكي خنان يدكان ما بو مال ما تخش بو ما نافيا ما تينا فاندران.
أي إنسان بالعالم بيحب بلده وبعشق بلده، ولكن الأزمة اللي حاصلة في سوريا تجبر أي إنسان أنه يبحث عن ملجأ آمن أو بلد آمن لأجله لأجل زوجته. لأجل أطفاله.
Everybody stay down, stay calm.
Everybody sit down and keep calm, okay? We take you all up.
عرف حالي اني جاي على الموت وجينا بقوارب الموت، قوارب مطاطيه، قارب مطاطي يحمل 140 شخص 150 شخص 140 شخص هو بيسع 20 شخص.
Some of them are carrying with them traumas that make them move. Some of them being victims of worst possible abuses. So if we deny access and if we deny protection to those people, we are committing the most serious sin.
أنا كان عندي فكرة عن أوروبا بس ما توقعتها هيك يعني. أنا بعرف إنه أوروبا بلد الحضارات. بس أنا بالنسبة اللي شفت تعامل البلدان اللي مريت فيها نهائيا يعني ضرب إهانة كل شيء تعامل سيء كان يعملونه فيه. فإنه كان الشعور في ناس عم تبكي في ناس ندمت بالساعة اللي طلعت عم تقول في ناس عم تقول كانت تقول إنه يا ريت أنا متت بسوريا ولا طلعت.
They have their human rights that have to be respected, which means that they should have an opportunity to apply for asylum.
في السوريين ياسانين حتى النام عم النام الشوارع. أنا كل العذاب تعذبته 6 شهور على الطريق تحت المطر وقطعت جبال وديان وغابات وما كنت يأسان لحتى يجي اي اسون واخر مرحله بدي اوصل فيها على بريطانيا.
You've got a swarm of people coming across the Mediterranean seeking a better life, wanting to come to Britain because Britain has got jobs, it's got a growing economy, it's an incredible place to live, but we need to protect our borders.
Tens of thousands of people have come out on the street to protest what they call essentially an invasion.
It is very dangerous and unacceptable to portray migrants as people who are invaders, who are threatening culture of the host countries. In Lebanon, it's over 1 million refugees. So if tiny little country can take care of over 1 million refugees, well, I think Europe can take care of 200,000. Investing huge resources in additional patrols and raids in identifying migrants will not stop migration. If you seal the door, people will go through the window.
We don't have the resources to support all the victims of conflict around the world and to provide them with the very minimum level of protection and assistance.
The world became a mess, and if people think that humanitarians can clean up the mess, they are wrong. We no longer have the capacity to pick up the pieces.
عشنا حياة صعبة ولكن احنا على ارض اوروبا ولكن قلوبنا ببلدنا ان شاء الله.
الواحد اللي يخلي وطنه دوم حزين والله دوم حزين.
Do not try to prevent migration by killing a dream of having a safe haven, of having security and having economic prospects. Try to provide for better protection of human rights and for freedom from fear and want.